from the Depths Instant Tutorial.
Welcome back to Jimmerism Total Nerdery Channel. Today, we will test different types of damage patterns using Cram Cannons. I highly recommend you to check out our APS damage pattern tutorial as well, if you want to see the different types of damage patterns when it comes to APS. APS and Crams are quite different. We're going to fire all of the main shells in succession so you can see their damage types. Now this Cram Cannon, as you can see, is pretty huge. And you might imagine that the shell is then very powerful. And this is necessarily not the case. Now you can see that the reload time of this shell is 6 seconds, which is pretty fast for a Cram Cannon. So the size basically does so it shoots fast rather than super powerful. So, if we go in here into Cram settings, we can set the gauge. The larger gauge you have, the fatter shell basically, the more powerful the shell can be. Under Configure Loadout, we can choose between the Hardener, the High Explosive, the Frag, and the EMP to kind of mix different types of pellets to make the type of shell we want. And we're going to try each of these in succession. Now, if we add payload compactors, the reload time will be a lot longer. Like now, it's 20 seconds, and the shell is thus vastly more powerful. We're gonna set this to 0, so that you can see the damage of a normal, non-payload compacted 200mm shell. And this is only hardeners. So if this was a super small cannon that would fire this shell, it would do the same damage. However, the super small cannon firing this shell would probably need a couple of minutes to reload, so that's the difference. Let's fire the hardener shell. And there we can see, it did some damage right there. And if we fire again in slow motion, the shell comes in and there, it goes through. So it would have penetrated many crafts in one shot, but well, not this block. Let's now test the high explosive regular 200mm shell. And again. Not so impressive. And now a frag shell with a default 60 degrees of fragmentation angle. And again. Here we have a frag shell, 180 degrees fragmentation. And we're also gonna try something low, like 5 degrees of fragmentation angle. Almost like armor piercing. There is actually one shell more we need to try from the basic one, and that's EMP. To test the EMP, we need to add a couple of EMP susceptible components. And there we go. And look! The EMP fried them all. Let's try again. And there is actually one more shell that has recently been added to the game when making this video. And that is, we go here and we select Hardener Pellet Weight to max. Then we go to the fuse box and we're gonna add the hollow point tip conversion. This converts this armor piercing shell to a hollow point shell. And the damage gets flattened out just like that. Let's try again. To make the damage much more serious, we need to add some compactors. Now we have a reload time of 13 seconds instead. So, a little more than the doubled with just a few compactors. Now we're gonna fire the same shell we just fired, but with a couple of compactors, and you'll see the difference. Doubling the reload speed is definitely worth this damage. That's a lot of damage. Here we have a normal kinetic shell with the same compactors. Shoots straight through. Explosive. Now we're talking. Frag, 80 degrees. You saw those individual frags just got into there and penetrated through their particular direction. Here we have frag 20 degrees. This would have done colossal internal damage for sure. What happens if we fire a shell, which is mixed high explosive and frag with some compactors? Well, we got huge internal damage and surface damage. We got them both. Now we're going to play around a little bit with fuses. Here in the fusing box we have low-high altitude, which is good for exploding like around aircrafts or stuff like that. We have time from launch, and then we'll need a laser rangefinder cram part to kind of make it explode when we want, when it's close to the vehicle. We have inertial, which will decrease the chance of the shell bouncing off, because if we have this shell we just fired, which is high explosive and frag, we would want to have an inertial fuse on it, because we want it to explode on the surface of the crafts, and of course this fires at the straight wall, so it will always kind of hit and then never bounce. But to make it not bounce, the inertial is great. The penetration depth is what we're going to use. That's so that we can explode a shell when we are inside of the armor. So we're going to set this to, I think 8 meters is kind of very nice. And we can go to this thing. Because to use this feature, we also want to have some hardener pellets. So something like that, apply this to the cannon, we can see now it's 16 seconds reload time, 14, that's more close. And we can now fire it and see what type of damage it does. And it did a lot of damage. You can see the entry hole is kind of small, and then it comes in here 8 meters and explodes inside. And this shell would have obliterated most vehicles. Here we have the exact same shell, but the fuse is now set to 12 meters. And there you see, it didn't pass through 12 meters of blocks, so it didn't explode, which is why you don't want it to over-penetrate. Let's try 9 meters. There it goes, the entire internals got blown away. Instead of using high explosive, we could have used frag in this scenario. And with this type of setup, we would want the fragmentation angle to probably be somewhere around 180. And then we can set the penetration depth to back to 8. And there we go. The frags got spread out all inside of it. If you want more surface damage, and also penetrating damage at once, one thing that you can do which is pretty interesting is to make this a hollow point. And then we go into this one and we see the loadout. We have hardener, we have frag, that's nice. Then we go to the fragmentation angle and set it to something low, like 11. And let me show you what happens. There it goes. It does quite much surface damage, and then the fragmentations go in and make the, well, internal damage as well. So if we, for example, go here and set the frag pellets to be a little less, but set the fragmentation angle to something even smaller, we can see what this does to the shell. In slow motion. There it goes. You can see the hollow point did the surface damage, and then the frag got a thin line of frags to do damage inside. So basically, you can combine this all you want. So for example, we can have a high explosive frag end hardener like that. Just apply it, see what you get. Something nice like that. And set a little penetration depth fuse to detonate at like 4 meters in. And then we of course need to play around with the fragmentation angle. Let's set it to 30 something. All right, what does this? Well, it works pretty well as well. Does all kinds of damage. First, got in here, exploded, killed this, and then the frag took out that. So you can get all kinds of interesting patterns to do the exact type of damage you need to take out the craft you need. And of course, don't forget about EMP, it's just boring to show the damage. Well, I hope this has explained all you need to know about the CRAM damage types so that you can make the shell you want. This has been Jimodism, and we're signing out.